What keeps Cheerios fresh as a brand, a billion-dollar brand, is far from simple. It takes a massive investment in innovation. General Mills has fortified its staff with data scientists.
We're up almost 40-fold in the number of data
scientists. 40-fold?
40-fold.
Wow.
The number of data scientists in the organization since 2018.
Now, you could say that data is the secret sauce here in the test kitchen. General Mills has always used consumer insights to guide product development. Now, data analysis and AI tools have been added to the recipe.
We've been applying AI and machine learning throughout our entire business. So whether you're in the finance function or whether you're in supply chain or marketing or whether you're in research and development, really across the spectrum.
Our entire innovation process has really dramatically changed in the past 10 years or so. Mm-hmm. We've gone from a place where we were just doing a handful of models, you know, in the thousands on mm-hmm. a monthly basis to now we're close to 6 million models running on a monthly basis, 500 million different predictions across various parts of the organization, including supply chain, but also leveraging those tools on the marketing side mm-hmm. to help us iterate, for example, on campaigns, marketing ideas, targeted media to get the right message to the right consumer at the right time.
So has that sped up the R&D process?
It helps us everywhere. For example, we've been able to reduce waste in our manufacturing sites where we use these predictive AI tools enabled by data to find opportunities in all parts of the production process to reduce waste. And we found in plants where we've employed these tools, we've seen a 20 to 30% reduction in waste. It's almost $20 million a year of reduction of waste just from these data tools.
General Mills is generating returns on what Kofi Bruce calls foundational investments in data and technology that began in earnest in 2020. It's paying off with new products.
It actually starts upstream with all of our consumer market intelligence organization giving us information on what relevant jobs we need to be doing for the consumer that aren't being solved right now by the products that are in market. It leads to things such as opportunities to improve the product itself, if it's our existing core product, to line extensions and new flavors, and sometimes to entire new categories.
When you're making these R&D decisions, what's the general time frame that you look to for creating something? Is it 5 years, 10 years? Like, what are you looking
for? No. We're always looking for a much shorter iteration cycle. I mean, you know, obviously some ideas do take longer, but, you know, we're looking to be able to get ideas to market, you know, hopefully a year or two or less.
Not every General Mills innovation follows the same pathway to market. The company invests in ideas at every stage of development.
The core of this recipe is a product that came up through our disruptive growth group. We've got a team called G-Works, which is our internal incubator. Mm-hmm. And it's really about finding opportunities to serve the consumer in ways that aren't met presently in our core businesses. Mm-hmm.
Carpe Diem is a low-carb whole wheat pasta designed to taste the same as regular pasta, but with more fiber and fewer calories.
The thing with disruptive trends is you don't always know in the early stages. Maybe there's an idea or a job that isn't necessarily being done well by all the products in the market, and there's an insight, and usually a nugget of a consumer insight about what that job is. And you need to play it out a little bit. So our entire disruptive growth team is about sort of playing some of these ideas out. If you miss certain key trends in the early stages, if you aren't clear about what's making those small disruptions in the early days successful, then you can end up with a large scale disruption to your business.
I might not fit squarely in Carpe Diem's target audience, but I wasn't going to leave the test kitchen without a taste.
It looks very delicious. I think that's definitely a hit.
Yeah.